Silent Night. It's one of the most beloved Christmas carols. It's been around for near almost 200 years. It is sung in many languages and loved by people around the world. And its origins can be traced back to the little Austrian village, Oberndorf by Salzburg. Just like our Savior had a humble beginning in Bethlehem 2,000 years ago, Silent Night, or Stille Nacht, Heilige Nacht, as it would have been known in that small Austrian village, had very humble origins. Silent Night was composed by the village priest Joseph Moore in 1816 and was originally a poem. At Moore's request, Franz Gruber composed the accompaniment to the song in 1818. Originally, the song was arranged to be played on a guitar. On December 24th, 1818, Silent Night was first sung at the Midnight Mass in St. Nicholas Church. Master organ builder Karl Marocker heard the song and requested a copy. He passed it along to traveling singers, and this song of humble origins eventually found its way into royal courts and high cathedrals. Silent Night has been performed by hundreds of artists, sung in churches across the world, and has a special place in the hearts of many at Christmas time. It was even sung on the battlefield in French, English, and German during the famous Christmas Truce of 1914. Like no other Christmas carol, Silent Night captures the essence of that first Christmas night when angels announced our Savior's birth.
Silent night,
The next song the elementary will sing is called One Star. And she brought forth her firstborn son and wrapped him in swaddling clothes and laid him in a manger. Think about that. What an inauspicious beginning for the Son of God. Christ, God's Son, King of glory, wrapped in swaddling clothes and lying in a feeding trough for barnyard animals. As one song says, it seemed like such a strange way to save the world. Yet he came, humbled himself, and eventually would submit to death so you and I might live with him in eternity. When you see the manger this year, remember the cross.
Star, I believe the light can shine the way.
As you celebrate Christmas this year, I'd ask you to stop and pause and remember, for across the world, there are many that are away from their family, who are serving our country in the armed forces. Think about those in Iraq, Afghanistan, Kuwait, Uganda, Germany, England, Guantanamo Bay, South Korea, many from our own church. Tonight we had originally planned to try to speak with, over Skype, Mr. Chris Vicente, who's away from his family in South Korea, but due to security issues, they would not allow it. But be sure you think about those, and those that are home here to stateside, celebrating Christmas, missing somebody that they are very close to. Our brave soldiers and sailors, airmen and Marines, all that serve their nation and serve the cause of freedom, remember them this Christmas. Even though they're away from us, Christmas can still bring great joy to their hearts and to many of those around the world. The thoughts of families and friends and fellowship, and most importantly, the thought of the birth of the Savior brings a peace and a joy that is unexplainable. And bring that to the hearts of many, no matter where they are. It's our last song tonight. Christmas is Christmas, wherever you are.